Hi all, welcome back to my lecture series. This is Muthuminal R, Assistant Professor from the Department of Agricultural Engineering at SNS College of Technology. Today we'll see the continuity of the previous lecture series Ozone Layer under the unit Earth's Climate System at the subject Climate Change and Adaptation for the students of final year 7th semester. Before going into the session, let's have a small recap what we have seen at the previous session. We have seen what is ozone, how the ozone is formed, what is an ozone layer, how the ozone layer can be depleted, and what could be the impacts caused due to the reduction of ozone layer's thickness, and what is UV radiation, and what is the role of ozone layer. Today we'll see the brief note on the ozone layer and its importance. So ozone layer is always denoted by the term O3, and here it is a gas composed of three atoms of oxygen, and it is also termed as bluish gas, which is harmful to breathe since this gas can't be used for respiration purpose. Nearly 90% of Earth's ozone is at the stratosphere, and that layer of ozone is said to be as ozone layer. Here I have shown you a diagram of ozone along with the application of hole here. As you guys can see, this is the Earth's surface, and here we do have the ozone layer as a blue thick line. And this lower part of atmosphere is said to be as lower atmosphere. This is how the sunlight will get penetrated through towards ozone layer and reach Earth's surface. If the ozone layer is in good condition, what happens in the sense, the UV radiation or the ultraviolet rays emitted by the sun will be penetrated towards the ozone layer. And this ozone layer will help us to absorb the ultraviolet radiation, that is, it will absorb UVB and UVC groups. Since we also know at the previous class that UVB and UVC is more responsible for creating serious disasters over the environment and also to the living beings. So if that's the case, if we are able to infiltrate or absorb those hazardous radiation, then it will not affect our Earth's surface. Since the ultraviolet passes here, as you guys can see, it has been absorbed. And only the sun's rays, which is not going to be a serious effect over the Earth's atmosphere, will be penetrating towards the ozone layer. If think of a way that there is a ozone hole, I have said there is going to be an ozone hole, that ozone holes has caused us serious disasters, and we have also recorded like that we have seen at the previous session. Here at the pictorial representation, you guys can see there is a hole. Okay, if there is a hole, what happens? There is no ozone layer here. So the sunlight and the ultraviolet radiation penetrates directly towards the Earth's surface. So if that's the case, what happens? It will cause a serious disaster. That is how the ozone works. Okay, this ozone absorbs a bandwidth of ultraviolet radiation, that is, as I have said, UVB and also UVC. Okay, so this is the ozone layer. So how many layers are available? Because we have been keep on studying from our schooling days that at the atmosphere, we can split them up into lower atmosphere and the upper atmosphere, among which the first 10 kilometers will be denoted as troposphere. Next 40 kilometers will be denoted as stratosphere. And in between troposphere and stratosphere, the ozone layer will be available. And the next layer above 40 kilometers will be mesosphere, and next to that of mesosphere, after reaching 100 kilometers, the next 300 kilometers would be thermosphere, and finally 400 kilometer altitude will be exosphere. Okay, so here what we are seeing throughout our ozone layers and everything, and role of ozones is basically dependent upon the earth troposphere and the ozone layer and the next layer, that is stratosphere. Okay, so this is how the ozone layer is formed. That is, oxygen plus sunlight will react together, and after the reaction it will form into three molecules of oxygen, that is three atom oxygen atoms will together form ozone. Okay, so here I have given you a separate split up that chemically it forms oxygen molecules. That after it has been reacting with the UV, it gets dissipated as two atomic oxygen, and this atomic oxygen quickly combines with the other oxygen molecules to form ozone. So that means that the ozone can be formed when it is chemically reacting with UV, as the UV is getting absorbed. But what happens if there is no ozone molecule, only oxygen molecule is available, then it will get dissociate into atomic oxygen, and which has to combine with other oxygen molecules to form ozone. This is what I have said. The ozone layer can be regenerated by itself at certain period of time. So it is naturally, the process is available from a season of August to October. It will get depleted by itself, and after the depletion it will get regenerated. But what we are doing in the sense, due to the technological development, we are emitting larger amount of carbon dioxide towards the atmosphere. So since due to that, it is affecting the ozone layer, and also it creates ozone hole. This is how the atomic oxygen gets depleted in a larger amount, so that the ozone layer is reaching its limit to regenerate itself. Okay, so this is what I have prepared for today's class. See you at the next class. Thank you.